I don't know whether we're going to get him tomorrow, or a month from now, or a year from now, but we're going to get him.
Dead or alive?
The United States has conducted an operation that killed Osama bin Laden, the leader of Al-Qaeda, and a terrorist who's responsible for the murder of thousands.
It's time to stop being so gullible. How many times have we caught our government and other governments lying to us? They lied about the Gulf of Tonkin in 1964 to get us into the Vietnam War. Said that attacks happened to our ships that never occurred. It's now been declassified that it was totally staged. We were lied to about WMDs, weapons of mass destruction, in a premeditated way to launch the war against Iraq. We were told Saddam was training Al-Qaeda. They showed us the satellite photos of the beached aircraft that they were training in. Turned out it was all a lie. They showed the world, once they took over Iraq, the mobile anthrax labs that launched the attacks on America. Turned out it was a super U.S. government strain and launched out of Fort Detrick, Maryland. And the anthrax mobile labs were British hardware sold to the Iraqis on record that were for pumping up hydrogen balloons to direct artillery during the Iran-Iraq war years before. The point is, they premeditatedly lie to all of us. They lied to us about Private Jessica Lynch. Remember that whole story? She didn't fight valiantly in the resupply convoy. It was the men that did, but they wanted to have a PR stunt to get women to join the military, so they said the men cowered while she got up there like Audie Murphy machine gunning the Iraqis. Turns out she cowered in the vehicle. The Iraqis took her to the hospital, and then the Iraqi military pulled out as the U.S. took over. The Iraqi doctors went. I mean, do you remember all this? To the U.S. forces, said, "We have some of your people here. Please come." And they got Jerry Bruckheimer on the phone, the Pentagon did, the famous director of Black Hawk Down, and said, over satellite feed, help us script saving her from enemies. But then things got more interesting before I get into the whole bin Laden fable. Members of her unit started talking to the press saying she cowered in fear and none of this was real, so they started dying in car wrecks and being shot in the head. And finally, Lynch came out and said, look, it's all fake, none of it's true. The Pentagon told me to lie. Remember that NFL player, the big star, Pat Tillman, joined the military after 9/11, went over to Afghanistan, wrote letters home to his family saying, this is all a fake war. There's no Al-Qaeda here. It's about controlling the poppy fields. Well, we heard he was charging an Al-Qaeda emplacement. Might as well have been an Easter Bunny emplacement or a Lucky Charms emplacement, and was killed by Al-Qaeda valiantly. Another recruiting tool even in death. Turns out the Pentagon knew he was planning to go home and speak out against the war, and that wasn't about to happen. So he was shot at a distance. He hid behind a rock, begged for help. The black op team went up, shot him in the face three times with a one burst from an M16 with a three-inch pattern from about a yard and a half away. And the Army coroners wouldn't lie and said the evidence showed he'd been murdered. He wasn't charging an Al-Qaeda nest. You know, I could go on for hours with lies. And I could go on for hours about the lies of the bin Laden fable on May 1st, a few weeks ago. And we've had the international media across the board attack us and call us conspiracy theorists for simply pointing out the inconsistencies in the official fable itself. But before I get into the latest developments, I just want to be clear. I was told by Dr. Pachinik, who was the co-author of Tom Clancy's book and who has been a major Hollywood producer with huge Tom Clancy films that have come out, who did write the psychological warfare manuals for the CIA and State Department. I was told in 2002 by him, and I've since interviewed him again, that bin Laden had died of Marfan's disease. You can only live a few years with that. He had total kidney failure. Nobody lives longer than 6 years, even on dialysis. And it came out in CBS News that he indeed was at the American hospital being visited and treated by U.S. doctors and the CIA months before 9/11. We'll play a short clip of that CBS newscast with Dan Rather for you.
CBS News has been told that the night before the September 11th terrorist attack, Osama bin Laden was in Pakistan. He was getting medical treatment with the support of the very military that days later pledged its backing for the U.S. war on terror in Afghanistan. Pakistan intelligence sources tell CBS News that bin Laden was spirited into this military hospital in Rawalpindi for kidney dialysis treatment.
So we know bin Laden died a long time ago. And then I interviewed, off record, two high-level Bush administration people that blew the whistle for me in 2002. We were the first to report that. Then Madeleine Albright came out on Fox News with Morton Kondracki's show and said they have his body frozen or plan to roll it out in the 2004 election and that they better not. Then Walter Cronkite, the late Walter Cronkite, very high-powered at the time, deep member of the elite organizations, came out and said the same thing. Teresa Hines Carey. But that's just setting the table. We already knew he was dead, okay? So don't tell me the government won't stage stuff. You know, I get emails and see comments on some of these videos we've put out that have 800,000, 900,000 views covering this bin Laden situation, and I'll see comments like, well, they've got a face print. They've got his DNA. Oh, really? And that's been released? No, it hasn't been released. I mean, the FBI crime lab was on record over a decade ago framing people on an industrial scale. Look at all the other crime lab scandals where they frame people in Houston, Texas, and San Francisco, California. Thousands of people a year on record. They just frame people. But they won't even release that fake evidence. They won't release a photo, but select members of the Senate are allowed to see it. They don't want Photoshop experts being able to look at it. But then there's all the other lies. We're told there was a 40-minute firefight, and on the news they put up animations of bin Laden firing and fighting, a guy that could hardly walk 10 years ago with his disease. Turned out that wasn't true. They told us he used his wife as a shield. Turns out that wasn't true. Said it was this huge, elaborate palace. Looked like a Chicago crack house or Dallas crack house to me. Then we're told that the Navy SEALs were told to go in and kill him, and that he resisted, but he didn't resist. Then that they were to capture him, but they went ahead and still killed him. If he's the biggest intelligence prize for the 160 buried nukes in the U.S., they tell us, and KSM says there's nukes, and that if we kill bin Laden, this is weeks before getting you all scared, that they're going to nuke us, why didn't they get that intelligence asset back if waterboarding's so great and gave us the leads, which they now admit isn't true? They're trying to sell us on torture because we'll put up with that, we'll put up with anything. If he's the greatest intelligence asset in modern history, why didn't they capture him? Lies, lies, lies. Then we were shown that Situation Room photo. And there was Obama looking tough. He's a guy who's decisive. Hillary was, oh my gosh. Yeah, when she called in all those hits, all those Arkansides, she's real. Oh, somebody's being killed. Turns out it was all fake. They told us they were watching live video feeds. Days later, actually, there's no live video feed and they weren't watching anything. Well, you can look at the photo and see it was staged. The way they rolled out the terror alerts 2 weeks before, the way they started rolling out that, oh, you're going to have presidential warnings on your cell phone and the government's going to break in at telescreens at malls and Walmart and that we've got to warn you. Oh, and then when they killed him, they told us, now the terror attacks are much worse. We've got to take all your rights and have TSA-trained goons at bus stations, train stations, on the streets. They're going to hit us. It's all over. Give your rights up. Government wants to take care of you. Don't be mad about the banker bailouts. Don't be mad about the depression. Believe the government. We're not even in a recession. Unemployment's only 9%. Even 60 Minutes admits 22%. So does every other major economist worth their salt. We live in a total system of lies. Then I see all the big mainstream news articles saying, oh, what's Alex Jones going to do now? They've released five videos captured in the compound. And all of the, quote, new videos but one, and we've written articles about this and show the still images side by side, are previous bin Laden videos that were released many years ago. And notice he never ages. And we have the CIA admitting last May that they have released fake bin Laden videos before in the Washington Post. So we have a government that lies to us constantly, admits they've made fake bin Laden videos. We get the five new videos, and they're all recycled videos. And so folks wouldn't notice that as much, because all they did was change some of the color tint on it in the chroma controls of the video editor. They didn't release audio on the new ones, because you can even watch the lips move with the old videos. It's not just the same old video, it's the same audio. So they didn't release that. That's how lazy they are. That's how stupid they think you are. Lie after lie after lie after lie after lie. In your face to sell you this. And it's not just that the five videos, that four of them are old recycled videos. It's not just that they didn't just release fake videos years ago. They also released re-edited real clips of bin Laden from 99, 2000 saying that they were new. They've been caught over and over doing this. No, a known front group for U.S. intelligence run by the daughter of a top Israeli spy, the Site Group, affiliated with the Intel Center that's been caught putting out fake bin Laden and Al-Qaeda and Adam Gadon videos before, comes out with the so-called new videos and confirms that, yes, Al-Qaeda agrees with Obama. They did kill bin Laden. Remember Governor Ridge, the former head of Homeland Security, 2 years ago put out a book admitting that they'd issued fake terror alerts for political gain? That's all the new terror alert system is about. That's all the calls for domestic internal passports are for, and now expanding the TSA to all transportation. This is a total takeover of our society, while the crooks that run Washington are selling us out to the big mega banks that have stolen $27 trillion and counting, mainly foreign banks. They're busy telling us to submit to their corruption and oppression, or the bad men wearing the scary turbans and beards are going to get us. This is nothing but pure theater. The videos are fake. They've been released by groups that openly are on the payroll of the Pentagon and who have been caught putting out disinfo before. The one video that is new is bin Laden from the side watching himself on TV. And this all coming from a system that has been caught lying over and over again. There are close to a million private contractor spies in intelligence now in the U.S. Trillions and trillions of dollars have been spent domestically on homeland security. This is the military-industrial complex creating a market to take over every industry in America, and to now come out with no travel, no fly list, where there's no judge, no jury. They just put you on the list and tell you that you can't own a gun if they say no judge or jury. That's being announced by Rahm Emanuel, Chucky Schumer, all these people. And Amtrak's coming out and saying, we agree, please start searching everybody, make people get government permission to even be able to get on a train. This is the Reichstag 2.0. And this was done as a desperate kickoff for Obama's reelection campaign that they've kicked off so he can carry out the globalist agenda. In closing, I want to go to the heart of the matter. We've seen White House advisors, former Clinton advisors like Robert Shapiro, openly write articles for the Financial Times of London and other publications. We've seen neocon writers in big syndicated columns talk about how much we need a new 9/11 to expand the empire and the domestic crackdown so the political ruling class can continue their criminal activity. They know they're in trouble. They know they've committed all these crimes and stolen all this money. So they need this supposed outside threat so we'll stand down and let them take over our lives. This is all a trial balloon, this bin Laden rollout to stage new terror attacks. As they've told you, more liberty has to be given up now that the terror leader has supposedly been killed. And terror attacks are imminent, including nuclear. Now, whether they go ahead with the new false flag staged event or not, it's a psychological form of terrorism. Do what we say or bad things are going to happen. Like Luigi in the old mafia days saying, I'm not going to burn down your family grocery store in New York, but you better pay me protection money because if you pay me, I'll stop those that will. And then if you don't pay him the protection money, he lets his cousin, Fredo, a.k.a. Usama bin Laden, the known admitted CIA asset, come burn down your grocery store. Or at least he says his cousin did it. It's very simple. And they are test marketing right now massive new stage terror attacks to use this whole Homeland Security grid against the American people. Remember, 2 years ago, law enforcement, FBI, Federal Marshal, State Police, sent me Homeland Security reports, State Police reports, where 90%+ of all anti-terror training is for Ron Paul supporters, in the fetters, people that want the Second Amendment, those that want to control our borders, people that want American sovereignty and are against this outside banking cartel takeover. It's that simple. So they're getting ready to stage new terror. They are testing you to see if they can get away with this. So please warn everyone you know, because this republic is in deep trouble. And the terror threat is a manufactured threat to menace the people. I'm Alex Jones. Don't give up your liberty. The spirit of 1776 can save this republic. Thank you for watching. Visit InfoWars.com and PrisonPlanet.com. When you're on the site, you can also tune in 24 hours a day to my daily radio broadcast. There's also a free iPhone app to listen to the syndicated radio show when and where you want.